this is different. There have been other major incidents that have happened, but I don't think this has affected any of us in this way. And we just wanted to share this on a personal level.
Al Roker, Craig Melvin, and Sheinelle Jones open up about raising black children and how they handled addressing the George Floyd aftermath with their families. The trio, along with Dylan Dreyer, led the Today Show's third hour on Monday with an honest discussion about the civil unrest that has ignited nationwide and beyond in the wake of Floyd's death and police custody. Al reflected on the guidance he gave nearly 18-year-old son Nick when it comes to being in the presence of law enforcement, especially when Nick was taking the subway every day before quarantine.
When we talk about our children, I mean, I've got almost 18-year-old son, and I've had to have this conversation with him that if you're stopped by the police, you are polite, you're quiet, you just say yes, you say no, you don't get belligerent. He's a big fella, he's a big kid, and he takes the subway to and from school and from home. And I was talking to Craig on Friday. I don't breathe a sigh of relief until Nick walks in that door, because I am afraid of what could happen. You know, he's in this New York City subway system, police officer, something happens. And I think this brought that to a head.
Craig's two little ones with wife Lindsay are biracial, but he agreed with Al that the toddlers will likely be seen as black, revealing that he anticipates his kids to face similar hardships he did, and it's something he and Lindsay, who is white, have discussed.
You've got biracial kids, yeah. And I think for society, they're going to see them as black kids.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. And Lindsay and I have had this conversation. I think sometimes people, unfortunately, they make certain perhaps assumptions. I'm a relatively young black man who's rearing a young black man living in the United States of America. Don't be fooled by the suits and some status. The number of times where you walk in a store and you know that
you are reminded.
Yes, you're constantly reminded. And we'd like to think that we live in some sort of post-racial America. And the reality is we're reminded time and time again that we do not.
Sheinelle is mom to a 10-year-old son and 7-year-old twins, but said they're old enough to understand the severity of our social turmoil, and have asked her to be direct with them about the upsetting footage they've seen on the news.
And there was the video constantly looping of the police officer having his knee on George Floyd's neck. And all of my kids can read. You know, I have two second graders and fourth grader. And Kyan said, and he read the subtext, and he said, "What's going on?" And I said, "Well," and like I was trying to, because I feel like they're already experiencing some level of trauma from being like away. So I wanted to insulate them. And I said, "Well, there was a police officer and he didn't do a good thing. He put his knee on a guy's neck and it killed him. So people are really upset." And I left it at that. And my husband said, "It's not a guy. His name is George Floyd."
Yeah.
And I looked over at my husband. I'm like, oh, are we doing that? Okay. So, and then Kyan looked at me. They were looking at me like, "You're not telling it. We've never had this happen ever."
You're not being a truth teller.
It looked at me and they were just like, "Your little mom answers are not good enough." So then I said, "Okay, everybody sit down. This is what happened."
Floyd died on May 25th after being arrested on suspicion of using a counterfeit $20 bill at a nearby convenience store. Eyewitness video showed Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin kneeling on Floyd's neck as he pleaded for his life. Chauvin and three other nearby officers were fired, and Chauvin has been charged with third-degree murder and second-degree manslaughter. He is due in court later this month. Floyd was just 46 and leaves behind a daughter and son of his own.